Morning students, today as we have discussed in our last class, like liquids have fixed volume but they doesn't have fixed shape. Now today we will learn about gases. What we say, solids have fixed shape and fixed volume. What about our liquids? Liquids, they have only fixed volume, like they will take the shape of the container. Okay? Now today we will learn about gases. Here, gases, do they have fixed shape and do they have fixed volume? We need to conclude this, whether they have fixed shape or fixed volume, or they don't have both fixed shape and fixed volume. For this, you are given an activity in your textbook. If you have a textbook, open page number 18. Now, look at the figures that. Now for this, you might be seeing a red color tube. This is a glass tube. What is your aim? Aim is gases don't have, they neither have definite shape nor definite volume. Next, aim is gases neither have definite shape, definite volume. Here materials are, look at the figure there. You might be seeing a glass tube and the rubber balloons are attached to the two ends of the glass tube. You are seeing that there is a rubber balloons attached to the two ends of the glass tube. In between there is a thing. We call this as a stopcock. Means, see, a stopcock is a thing, like if you want water, what do? You will open the tap, then the water will be coming up. If you don't want, what do? You will close the tap. Similarly, a stopcock is a thing, if you want to enter air into any balloon or something, we can open. If you don't want to enter, close the stopcock. Not only air, you can have for liquids also. Okay? Now for this activity, what do we require? A stopcock, two rubber balloons and a glass tube. Now, to this glass tube, first blow it into one rubber balloon. Take a rubber balloon, blow air into the rubber balloon. Attach it to one end of the glass tube. Okay? Now, after attaching it, close the stopcock. Okay? When I have closed, what happens? The air doesn't come out from the balloon. Now, take another balloon. Attach it to the other end of the glass tube. Don't blow air into the second balloon. Just simply attach a balloon to the other end of the glass tube. Now, when you look at the figures, the balloon which you have attached, first rubber balloon, it will be a bulged shape. Okay? Some air is there inside the balloon. To the second balloon, there is no air. Now, slowly open the stopcock. Does the air from the first balloon enters into my second balloon? Yes or no? Yes. Then what happens? My second balloon bulges. What happens to my After entering some air into the second balloon, again close the stopper. Now observe here first balloon. Thus, the air remains same as it was earlier. What do you say, children? The air will not be the same because some of the air has entered into your second balloon. Now, what happened to the shape of your first balloon? Is there any change in the shape of your first balloon? Yes. Okay. The volume, whatever air has occupied inside the first balloon, the volume also has changed. Okay. Gases, volume has changed and the shape of the balloon also has changed. Hence, by using this activity, what we have concluded? Gases neither have definite shape nor definite volume. If you want to see, in the first figure, how was your balloon? It is bulged. When we have opened this top cup, the air has entered into the second balloon. Thus, the shape of the balloon has changed, the volume of the air also changed, and the shape of the balloon also changed. Hence, below the figure, he has given volume and shape of the gases change. Okay? Hence, volume and shape. Volume, that means how much air it has occupied, also changes. And also what happened, the shape of the balloon also has changed. Okay, children, volume is changed, the shape of the balloon is also changed. Hence, we came to a conclusion that gases neither have definite shape nor definite volume. Okay? Now, after this, you have differences between solid, liquid, and a gas. Now, how to differentiate? Differences means here, first thing is solids. When you look at these solids, what we have done in the first activity, they have fixed shape. Your liquids, they don't have fixed shape. So the gases have fixed shape, no fixed shape. Come to the volume. Do the solids have fixed volume? They will have fixed volume. Your liquids, they don't have, but they will take the shape of the container. Your gases, they don't have any fixed shape or fixed volume. Like this, solid, liquid, gas. Okay? Now we are finding out the differences between solid, liquid and a gas. Fixed shape, they will take the shape of the container. They don't have any fixed shape. Fixed volume, they will take the fixed volume, but they don't have any fixed volume. Now solids, will they flow? If I place a brick on the ground, does it flow? No. They never flow. Liquids, if I pour water on the floor, what happens? Does it flow? Yes. Liquid flows. Your gases flows in all directions. Okay? Compressibility means, suppose, take your sponge. Okay? Now, the sponge is there. Can I press it like this? Yes or no? Yes. That is called compress. Or a spring you take. Press it like this. Does it move closer now? Yes. In your textbook also, he has given you compressibility. Solids cannot be compressed. Does your liquids can be compressed? You have in your textbook. Look at here. compressibility, cannot be compressed. Liquids slightly compressed. Gases are highly compressible. That's why we are able to fill it in cylinders, gases. In a gas, hydrogen balloons we are saying. Okay? These are some of the differences between a solid, liquid and a gas. Okay? See children, today those who are having textbooks, please buy the textbooks. You have a checkpoint there. You need to solve these blanks. Okay? Till now what I have told you, based on that topic, the blanks are there. Try to do them. If you are not getting, I will discuss them in the next class. And also you have some questions here. Answer the following questions. Okay. Now, next is arrangement of molecules in solids, liquids and gases. Today we will learn a small topic. Here, we are starting composition of matter. We have studied that matter is a substance that has mass and occupies space. Now there I have told you, inside the matter there are smallest particles. We call them as atoms. These atoms are the smallest particles. These atoms combine. What I said? Atoms combine to form a molecule. I have told you this. Inside any matter, there are smaller particles called atoms. These atoms are smaller particles. These atoms combine to form a molecule. Okay? In the next class, we will be learning how are these molecules arranged in your solid, liquid and a gas. Then we will wind up this chapter. Okay? Now today, note down your homework. Write an activity to show that gases have neither fixed shape nor fixed volume. Okay? And the remaining thing, I have given you blanks. Fill in the blanks I have given you. Fill in the blanks in your checkpoint. In textbook they are there. Try to do them. Okay? In the textbook some blanks are there. In the checkpoint, fill those blanks. Activity you must write in your own words. Okay? Don't copy the activity directly from the textbook. Write in your own words and fill the blanks in your textbook. We will discuss them in the next class. Okay, children, thank you.